Hi viewers, this is Smart Exeter. In this video, I will not be showing any formulas or formats, but I'll be using DAX formulas. I'll be showing you how to use add data model and remove data model. So this is like my previous videos where I have showed you how to create ranges, how to create tables. So this will be like how to create a data model and remove a data model. So suppose if you have a sheet over here and you have a look at the break-even analysis. So that, but before that, I'll be showing the different various areas where data model is available. So if you go to data queries and connections, you can see that the queries and connection is empty over here, and Power Pivot also. If you want to add measures, you should have something. You should have something in the data model. So this video will be how to add and delete in data model. So this is a data. This is my data. Database. Now I want to add this into a data model. So if you hit over here and add to data model, this is the first step. So we can see that it has been added to data model. From here also you can create a pivot table. And if I don't want to save, I don't need to save it automatically, it will be saved. So you can see my data model has been added. And you can check also if you have, you can see that if you use to external connections and tables, you can see when the data model is added, you will have a cube in this format. So this is going to demonstrate that this is added into a data model. Now if you want to remove it from data model, so what you can do is you can right click and delete. So you can see this is how to remove from data model. Again, if you go to insert pivot table, choose connection tables, you can see only the table is here. The table has been created for this, but there is nothing in data model. So there is nothing in Power Pivot. So adding this, before that I will be showing you one more way. Then you can go and see here, then we can manage, and you can see the thing is empty over here. So the step I showed you is a very simple step. You can click here and add to data model. Apart from that, you can do is insert pivot table, and here you can add this to data model. So when I click this and do OK, you can see it has been added to a data model. And again, you can go to Power Pivot, manage. You can see this has been added to the data model. Now, if you want to remove, I'm going to show you how to remove. I showed you before. One step is how to remove from here, how to right click and delete this. But I'm going to show you is good from the here also. You can delete this. We can delete by going to right click and delete this, and you will be asking yes. So it has been deleted. Now if you close this, we can see it has been deleted. So from data queries and connection, it has been deleted. And if you go to insert, if you go to, let me delete this also. If you go to insert, and if you go to use external tools, and if you go to tables, you can see all tables, working connection tables and output, there is nothing. If you go to all tables, you can see it has been deleted. So in easy and simple step is adding this to data model directly from here, or you can go to Power Pivot and add to data model. Or if you want, you can add to data model. If you can, you can, there are other ways to add to data model is by clicking there, and there are different options over here. From SQL Server, from Access, or if you can go directly from here and from other sources. So it will be guiding you to other sources. So please refer to my previous videos where I have my text, and where I have, we have to go to browse, and you can select something from the records. Or if you go to, if you go to Access, from Access, or even if you have some in Excel file, you can go next, and you can go and browse, and you can add, and that's it's for the other Excel files which are in different places. You can test the connection. So there are different methods also, or and but for if you have the same sheet in the same table, so you can just voice click here, and already it has been converted into a table. You can see this is a table one. So already Excel has made this as a table one. You can see the it has been made as table 1. Just we have to add this to a data model. So once you add this to a data model, now the it has been added to a data model. So I have showed you important tip and trick. So in my next video, I'll be showing you how to add measures. So the measures are like this. Now you can see if you have a new measure, you can get this dialog box. Before, if you don't have anything in the data model, suppose if I delete this, and now if you go and ask a new measure, you'll get there is nothing in the data model. So you have to create a table. If you don't want to create it directly, you can go and add to data model directly from here. Or if you are not convinced, you can go and you can add from here. So this is a very important video. This is the foundation for studying the DAX formulas. Please try this video so that you can get hands-free on this. I would like you to request to please comment on this video. Please like, share, and give me your opinions. And I would like to show you the next things, how to create the measures and connections for Power Pivot, so we can understand Excel more clear, Power Pivot more clearly, and we can do things necessary. So I hope you find this video useful. Please share this video, and I will see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.